The Drakelow Tunnels in Kidderminster, England is said to be one of the most haunted sites in the world. Through the years, I've heard countless stories of shadow figures, apparitions, and strange dark entities in the tunnel's 3.5 subterranean miles. It was built in 1941 to make weapons, tanks, and aircraft engines for World War II. But with the dawn of the Cold War, it was converted into a highly classified nuclear bunker until it closed in 1993. There are almost no records from this facility's top secret history, but a few known deaths have been reported. Three men were buried alive when a tunnel collapsed in 1941. And to this day, workers and visitors claim to see shadow figures lurking in this area. The apparitions of a woman and her young boy are seen in the hallways. And workers say a demonic entity roams the back tunnels. These reports are so common and consistent that the Drakelow Tunnels has gained a reputation as one of the world's most active hauntings. Katrina and I have been waiting for years to investigate the legendary complex. And now we will spend 72 hours locked down inside the former top secret facility, trying to unearth exactly who or what haunts the Drakelow Tunnels.
This is like a totally different world down here.
Yeah.
So,
paranormally speaking, what's been happening in this area?
We've had quite a number of people see a sort of shape of a lady with a child on a hip in the doorway just down there. And then right next door here, where we can go into now, the canteen, the candelabras have moved. Yeah, so this is the 1980s kitchen and canteen area.
Okay.
And see the candelabras up there.
Yeah,
sometimes we have events and we'll put the candles on those. And that's what I've suddenly become aware of it moving and just
the,
gently.
The whole thing is moving.
Yeah, it just starts to sway above my head.
What other experiences have people had in this space?
Quite often these people have heard sort of music coming from the back of the kitchen. I'm going to lead you through and show you that.
Okay. We'll follow you.
Yeah, so just at the back of the kitchen where the generator room is, you can hear sort of music playing. There's one occasion my son and I were changing the filters on the generator, so it was turned off. The place is in silence, obviously. And when we heard this, like, people talking and footsteps getting closer and closer to the door, you know, there was no mistaking it. There was people had walked up to that door. We went down to the door with the torches, shouting hello, and there was nobody.
Wow.
This area here, this is where we're now sort of heading towards the bottom corner. Quite often, people have had these strange reports of sort of half-man, half-dog-type sort of things.
Depends, right?
Like somebody's on the hands and knees, but they're hairy or furry.
So, like, they feel like a human pushing in on their knees, but they're very hairy.
Yeah.
Half-man, half-dog.
So, half-man, half-dog. Which is definitely one of the more bizarre stories I've heard in my time in this field. But we have to keep this in mind going forward in our investigation.
What was that? I heard footsteps walking up to me right now. There's someone standing there? I've been here for almost 2 days now, and I still can't sleep. I feel like there's something here watching me. There's someone down here with me? Who's down here? What was that? Holy shit. Is there someone over there? Look like a man moved down this way. What was that? Holy shit. What was that? Holy shit. Is there someone over there? I saw a man standing here. When I turned the camera, I could see him move back here. There's a man right there. Who is over there? Tell me what your name is. All my lights are dying right now. I only have my flashlight. I only have a little bit of battery left. I have to try to figure out how to get out of these tunnels fast. Oh, fuck. What was that noise?
Holy shit.
Oh, fuck. I can't see.
I really feel like something's following me right now, and I'm looking for it, but I'm also trying to get back to where Katrina is. All of a sudden, my IR light just dies on my camera, and all I have right now is my flashlight.
I need to find Katrina.
I've been sleeping all night. I don't really have anything happen to me. So for a change, I'm gonna go find Nick. I'm gonna wake him up and get our day started. Nick? Hello? What the fuck? Nick? I don't know where the fuck he is.
I'm gonna try to go through this crawl space here because I went down almost every tunnel and I don't know if I have to go through some wall to get back through. Is anyone back there?
Nick! Fuck.
What the fuck is this? Holy shit.
Nick!
I'm back here!
Katrina?
Yeah, it's me!
There's a man back here with me, ran right by me!
Oh my God, thank God you found me!
So what the hell? Did you not hear me screaming for you?
I couldn't find out where you were. I swear to God, I honestly couldn't figure out how to get back to base camp. I made a left, and I'm turning, and I'm hearing someone fucking following me. And then all of a sudden, I turn my camera, my IR light dies, I have my flashlight, and I swear I saw a man just move. What was that?